The joyful women, singing at the top of their voices, were celebrating National Women's Soccer Team's victory over Chipolopolo Queens of Zambia in a match that saw the Mighty Warriors qualify for the 2016 Africa Women's Cup of Nations. In October 2015, the Mighty Warriors also qualified for the 2016 Olympic Games, yet with such achievements, they still get second-class treatment from authorities. Why is gender discrimination in sports so visible when players get to the national team level? Legal and Administration Director of ACES Academy, which has contributed to both male and female teams, tells ZWM3 how they put equal effort in grooming their young players.
We started, I think, with just a small number. There were probably about 40 kids, and then we also saw a need to bring in the girls. Our coach, Elizabeth, also came when she was young, the age of about 12. She was, she came from Mbare and played for the national team for a while. And I think she also expressed a passion for wanting to develop or give back to the academy and to see other girls also thrive and become successful soccer players.
I think most of the people here, they think girls, they cannot play football. But to me, I can say you can play doing all the things.
Our training regime for girls and boys is exactly the same. They're given the same opportunities. The training exercises that they're given are exactly the same.
Despite similarities in grassroots training for both girls and boys, senior national teams are treated with a distinct difference. The passion and knowledge shown by the young female players shows that with equal support, sportswomen can reach greater heights.
Defender kuno doa muna singa chike bora. Euti muna rukwe ne bora. Mwasa kuchuka chiki muna nasu kwenye doma ndo doona. Nungufana utesa simbala koreese. Kutu bora sapile mgeti.
They need a lot of support from everyone, even at home.